Good morning, everybody. My name is Cameron Foltz. I am putting this out basically because I want to make YouTube videos. I do not have any editing software, so all of my stuff will be done in one take. I'm not really good at doing these things on one take because I've been doing this for the past 4 hours. So let's try and get it right this time. I do technology reviews on the technology that I have and the technology that I work with. That's a big range of things, and you'll come to find out as you join. Nintendo Wii, Nintendo DS, PS3, PlayStation Portable, Xbox 360, computer stuff, computer games, anything I can get my hands on, I'm going to do a review on. So, in the second half of my stuff will be going on to bullshit in the world, kind of the funny part of the show. So, watch for the technology, stay for the funny. Today I'm going to be doing the PSP Go. People who don't like the PSP Go, I'm sorry, I don't know why. I love this thing. 16 gigs of internal memory. It's also got a slot so you can add in the new memory stick, micro, or whatever the heck it is. Anyway, the M2, as they're trying to call it. Sony's putting out a new micro kind of memory card so you can take up less room and do that. Anyway, the highest one they've got out is 16 gigs, so you can bump this thing up to 32 gigs. Actually, it's somewhere like 29 or 30 or something like that, because you lose... Anyway. First off, when it's sitting in idle, it runs with that screen, which is the... just, I guess you could be like a universal screensaver. That's what it looks like with the regular stuff. You move left, right, just the same old PSP stuff. Nothing really different. The system actually works really well. The slide up is really nice. It's really clean. You got an internal microphone right there, the regular D-pad, you know, all the stuff that a normal PSP has. They got rid of the home button. They put a PS button just like on the PlayStation 3 controllers. You got your media control stuff there. You got your headphone jack and your charge port, USB port, everything like that is that plug right there. One of the cool things that I haven't seen anybody really talk about with the PSP Go is the fact that it is Bluetooth enabled. Now, as far as Bluetooth goes, you would think a headset, right? Well, what would you need a headset for? It's got a built-in microphone, and you can hook up, a headphone jack. What would you need a headset for? It's not for really the headset. What it's for is using a PlayStation 3 controller to attach to the PSP Go. It's a really awesome feature. I don't know why people haven't been talking about this more. It has a lot working for it, especially whenever you're talking about like regular PlayStation games that use the R2 and L2 buttons and a right analog stick. Ape Escape, Cool Borders, stuff like that. I've had a lot of fun with it. This system is great. I have way too much fun using the controller on a small system. Another cool thing about the system is the fact that it actually saves your game, like a pause on the actual game, and stores all the information on your actual current location in the game onto the system. Now, what that means is if you can't get someplace to charge this thing while it's going dead, you don't have to scramble to find a save point. Oh my god, what's the save point? Oh damn, it went dead! No. What happens is, you can either pause it yourself or keep playing, and once the system dies, it will automatically save the game as a paused save game file. Then you can go back to the game system, and right there between the system storage and the save data utility, there will be a resume game logo. You click on it and it goes right to it. It happened to me the other day. I was trying to cast a cure-all in Final Fantasy VII, and boom. All of a sudden, I ran out of battery. It paused the game so well that whenever I actually put a charge on it and turned it on and went to resume the game, Tifa's arms were still up. All right, she was still casting. And I continued with the game, mid-fight. It was so cool. Loved every second of it. One of the downsides to the system is the fact that this is your universal setup for everything. Now, the one problem I can see with this is if you're going to try and hook this system up to a TV, how are you going to be able to charge the system? I don't know if there's going to be a dual plug setup or something like that. I do not know. That's something for Sony to come up with and Sony to understand. I do not know how that works. So, other than that, I love the hell out of the system. I've had way too much fun with it. It's even got Skype. okay? The wireless internet connector on this thing, the Wi-Fi connection on this thing is so good. It actually comes with Skype, and you can put in your information and use Skype. I use it a lot. My little brother's in the Navy. My older brother is living in Grenada, so I keep in touch with my family like that. My mom lives in Houston. I live in South Texas. I really like the system. I'm really, really impressed with this system. It's been great for me. It's actually replacing my iPod. On to the bullshit of the day. I heard a couple months ago that they were actually going to be revamping the image of Cookie Monster on Sesame Street. Now, why they would revamp the Cookie Monster image, I really don't know. I mean, is he scary? I don't remember as a kid running around my school looking around every corner. Oh my god, the Cookie Monster's going to come around and eat me. I don't remember that. It's just not something that I worried about, I guess, when I was a kid. Is it because he eats cookies like a monster? Well, that's kind of the point, I thought. Look, if it's because Cookie Monster eats cookies like a freaking monster and just shoves them into his face, that's table manners. Teach your kids some table manners. Is it because he engorges himself on cookies and he eats a bunch of junk food? Well, how the hell is that his problem? The kid can't go out and buy his own friggin' junk food. The person who's buying the junk food for the kid is you. Why are you buying your kid junk food? That's bullshit. Why? What the fuck? I'm going to keep buying my kid junk food, but I want him to eat it in moderation. Okay, well, then teach him moderation. That shouldn't be something he learns from Cookie Monster. Your kid should not get life lessons from watching fucking TV. Anybody watch Cable Guy? That was a creepy fucking movie for me. Look, if your kid's acting like a fat slob because he sees a fat slob on TV, that's not the kid's fault. That's yours. Parent. Be a parent. Parenting is a verb. Act like a freaking parent and parent your child. I mean, come on. All you gotta do is take him outside and run him around for a little bit. Take him to the park. If your kid won't get off of video games, take away the video games. You don't have to have a reason. You're the goddamn parent. You know how many times I heard that in my life? Well, why can't I play video games? Because. What do you mean because? Because I fucking said so. You have any idea how many times I heard that? All the fucking time. Look. Be a parent. Take your kid to the park. Put him outside with his friends. Introduce him to some of the neighborhood kids. Start up a baseball league. Something. If your kid is acting like a fat fuck because he sees Cookie Monster acting like a fat fuck, that is not Cookie Monster's fault. And it shouldn't be the network's job to change that shit. It's yours, America. That's bullshit. I'm calling you on it. Look, I'm not an angry guy. I really am not. Well, at least I try to think I'm not. All you have to do is leave a comment. Tell me what's wrong with my page. Trust me. More feedback I get, the better this show's going to get. The more feedback I get, the editing stuff I'm going to get. This will be a good show. Enjoy it. Subscribe. Leave a comment. Look me up on Facebook. My name's Cameron Fultz. Y'all take care. And remember, people act like assholes because you allow them to act like assholes. And now you're going to see me stop the recording.